Hi everyone, come to share a journal I've been busy making. This is for a swap over on Junk Journal Junkies. It's not due till the beginning of February next year, but I wanted to get it done because I've got a few things going on at the beginning of the year. So it's a gutter book, a reader's digest. It's 7¾ inches by 5½ inches. We had to do a 2-signature 80 page. So this is what I've done. The lace on the side and a lovely image. I've used kits from Artie Mays and Ephemera's Vintage Garden. I've used craft tips on the inside to strengthen it. The pocket, the tag. This time around I've coffee dyed my papers. I haven't done that for quite some time now, but I just wanted it to look really vintage. That's a doily impression on the tag. Use page, a doily impression. Use my stamp, Charlene Sherald gifted me in a rack. And the story begins. Got a lovely altered paper clip here with some music paper. Some coffee dye paper underneath, some eyelash trim, and I fussy cut out the rose. So the rose was off a piece of paper from the kit and put glossy accents on the top. So it shimmers nicely. Used a piece of music paper. Used my negative space butterflies. Sweet envelope that I've stuck down just so I can put some tags in it. I've stuck with the blues, teals and pinks throughout and added the roses in. This is a piece of the ephemera from the Artie Mays kit. It just opens out and I've punched some little birds and glued them in. There's a writing space on the back. Sits in this wee pocket. A bit of lace and some tags and a wee clock. Another lovely pages from Artie Mays kit. Beautiful birds. A homemade doily. Double tags, a nice stamp with the sentiment on it, double tags, used a piece of the doily to make a little tuck pocket, this is from Ephemera's Vintage Garden, used my negative space on one of the pages here, so we find butterfly. The coffee dye goes very well with the colours in this. So a page out of Ephemera's Vintage Garden. Some mason jars. And tag in the front. And tag in the middle with a butterfly. Just layered them up quite nice there. Just left a lot of space in this one for journaling. That's what it's meant to be, a journaling book. So whoever gets it, we'll have a lot of writing space. Tag at the top. And this is tracing paper and I've printed out on it. It's come up very nice. I've done this before and enjoyed it. Nice stamp of the birds. The middle of the first signature is an envelope. There's some writing paper in here. Now this is from the kit and I've glued the music sheet paper on the back of this one. Thought music paper would look good. My edges have been punched with the Martha Stewart doily punch and I've used my vintage photo. The back of the tracing paper, printed on this side. Nice big stamp of the bird. Nice pattern with the coffee dyeing. Mason jar tag, just a wee tuck spot there. And journaling pages, double tags again. Two wee cards in there. Used my Gilettos on the seam binding and dyed all the ribbons. A doily. Piece of that beautiful paper. made a wee pocket here. This wee tag comes out as well, needs to be used. Another negative space butterfly. Wee side pocket here. Made that tag into a wee tuck. Here's one of my stamps, postcard stamp. And a doily with a butterfly in it. It's on the back as well. The end of the first signature. Second signature, I've got another altar paper clip. Music paper and the rose. And there's just a little tag behind there. Stamped edge. Yeah, big pocket. Another butterfly. And this wee one comes out of here as well. It's a wee cutie. And journaling pages. Just a lovely Kaiserkraft butterfly stamp up the top. A doily. Just a little wee half page up here. A lovely pocket with the roses on. Negative space butterfly. Over the back, a tuck at the back of the glycine bag, tag in it, and a tuck on the front. Got the doily image on the back of the mason jar. And a lovely pattern on the coffee dry paper. Lovely bird stamp again. More tracing paper. This is a piece out of Ephemeris Vintage Garden Chevy Birdie kit. Tiny wee pocket here from the kit. Wee mason jar you can write on the back of. Ephemeris Vintage Garden kit page there. I've made the doily and it just sits over top of the doily copy die impression. Birds of a feather stamp. Same envelope in the middle. And this time I left the back with the lines on instead of music paper. And inside a large tag. Copy dyed on the back so you can write on it. I've used my wee tags as stopper for the envelope. A lovely coffee dyed doily impression, the doily over top, the rose page. There's a little tracing paper with the eggs and the bird's nest. Used one of the lovely mason jars out of the kit as a wee tuck spot, and then this is like journaling. Wee card. You can write on the back as well. And a wee tuck pocket, tag, and butterfly. We have page, a doily. Those beautiful bird images again. Nice coffee dyed image. Just a little wee tuck down here with a couple of wee journaling tickets inside. These are all from Ephemeris Vintage Garden. Another mason jar with the birds. This time a beautiful piece of rose paper. You can write on the back. Sits on the large tag nicely. And the last page, another beautiful pocket, a tag inside, whoop, and a wee journaling spot. Some lovely crochet trim down the edge here. So there we go, that's my swap for over on the Junk Journal Junkies, the birds and butterflies. Thank you all so much for watching. Really appreciate the time you put into making your comments and watching my videos. I really do appreciate it. And I want to wish everyone a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year from Hubby and I. Hope you all have a lovely time with family and friends. Thank you very much.